Hey folks, welcome back to another project for the BTO, and this time is for May 2022. Today, let's go through the Jurong West BTO, where I'll go through the unit types, site map, as well as the price range that you can look at so that you can make a better decision on whether you should go for the Jurong West BTO. Let's go. Alright folks, so this is the Jurong West BTO project. The name is called Lakeside View for the May 2022 BTO. Now this project is actually located next to the Jurong Lake and Jurong Lake Gardens, bounded by Kang Ching Road and Yuan Ching Road. It has 7 residential blocks ranging from 11 to 18 floors, and you can select from a total of 1016 units. This project do offer a scenic view of the Jurong Lake Gardens as well as the surrounding greenery. It also has a few communal amenities such as the playgrounds, fitness stations and the usual stuff. Now looking at the project details, the estimated completion date is around 4th quarter 2026. So we are looking at around 4 years of building and completion time. Flat types and number of units, we do have 2 room flexi type 100 units, 2 room flexi type 2 355 units, 3 room 101, 4 room 246 and 5 room 214, total of 1016 units, which is actually quite a big project if you ask me for 1000 over units in a BTO project. So let's take a look at the town map to see what are the surrounding amenities and stuff. Over here you can see that your nearest transportation option is actually Lakeside MRT station. And if you walk along Yuan Ching Road to your project, I think that's around a 10 to 15 minutes walk, depending on your speed. And right behind you, you do have Yuan Ching Secondary School. And if you look over here, you can have a scenic view of the Jurong Lake Gardens. For people who are into feng shui, you will know that having water bodies at the front of your property signifies good wealth flowing into your house. So for those people who prefer a water-facing unit, make sure you have a low queue number. And there are actually a lot of activities you can do at Jurong Lake, right? You can do like a walk, exercising, you can even do kayaking. I think there are a few low cost options such as water sports as well. And at the southern part along Corporation Drive, you do have your very famous Taman Jurong Market and Food Center. That's where you can get your low cost hawker food, as well as your community club if you want to do some social and community activities. There's even a new Active SG Sports Village under construction, so by the time that your BTO is finished, I'm quite sure this will be completed soon. So here are some of the facilities along Jurong West Town. You can see that there's Active SG Park, Jurong Lake Gardens, MRT Station, schools and community club. Let's take a look at some of the pictures for this project. Over here we have how the project looks like from the artist's impression. The color theme will be light blue, grey and white. You can see that some blocks are taller than the others, so that means an angled design, and this is probably the multi-storey car park. Here's the internal area, so you can see that the painting is actually not straight. It's like a curvy and wavy pattern. I think it's a resemblance to the waves at Jurong Lake Park. So over here is the site plan where you can look at further details of the lakeside view. So you can see that for facilities and communal areas, we have playground, fitness station, elderly fitness station, hard court. And then for social amenities, we do have future amenities, residence network center, childcare center, and even a café. So where are these located actually? So number 10 is the location of a café, and it's very nearby to the possible bus bay and future shelter. You do have a 7th floor multi-storey car park over here with a rooftop garden access. So you can see that the entire project is linked with sheltered walkways. So if you do not want to walk to the nearest MRT, Lakeside MRT, you can actually walk along the sheltered walkways and then take a bus from the future bus stop. Maybe you take a 1 or 2 stops to reach Lakeside MRT, so you don't have to walk like 10 to 15 minutes under the hot sun or under heavy rain. And there are already existing bus bay and shelter here, so I believe there are existing transportation options to go to the nearest MRT. For blocks and units wise, we do have 7 residential blocks from 341A to 344C. The highest floor is actually 18 floors at 341A. And they do have all the options for the residentials. We have 2-room flats, 3-room, 4-room and 5-room. So if you do want a shot at the 5-room flat, I think the Jurong West project will be suitable for you, because we have around 200 over units for your selection. So if you ask me for my preference of which unit or which stack should I look for, I would say I'm one who actually prefer to look over the Jurong Lake Garden. So units that are facing along Yuan Ching Road will be my preference. So like stack 271 and 273. In fact, any unit that is facing this direction, I'll be good. Even if it's a partial view like these two stacks at 341B, right? I'm sure that as long as the floors are above the car park, you can actually have an unblocked view of the Jurong Lake, which will be really nice and scenic. Anyway, that's just my own preference. I believe as a family, you all can decide with your partner what is the ideal unit, because it also depends on whether your queue number is suitable to select the units that are really popular. Now with that, let's go to the price and flat details, starting with the 2-room Flexi Type 1. We do have 107 to 145,000, and it's actually a very small area for this 2-room Flexi Type 1, right? We are looking at 38 square meters, so once you enter the door, you do have a very small kitchen with a single bathroom and water closet, and then you have a bedroom attached with the living room with a sliding door. I think this is a very typical Type 1 layout, suitable for one or two persons only. And since Jurong West is a non-mature estate, singles above 35 can apply for it as well. Now let's look at Flexi Type 2. Flexi Type 2 is actually slightly larger than Type 1. The price is 133 to 180,000. Internal area is actually at 48 square meters, so slightly larger than Type 1, because you do have space for a little dining table, or you can make it like a home office as well. If not, you can even make it to like a helper's room if you want to have a live-in domestic helper to take care of senior citizens. Living in a 2-room apartment, I think a helper will be really beneficial. Also, you can note that the kitchen is slightly larger than Type 1 as well, because it's an L-shaped kitchen rather than a squarish kitchen. So you can expect to put more household appliances if you want to do heavy cooking stuff. Now let's move on to the 3-room flats. So 3-room flats is around 215 to 265,000 for Lakeside View. The resale flat nearby transactions are around 350 to 400 over $1,000. So if you look at the layout ideas for your home, this is a 3-room floor plan that comes with 2 bedrooms, one being the master bedroom and one being the common bedroom. The master bedroom will have an ensuite toilet attached to it, and then you do have another common toilet that's available along the common corridor. Now for the kitchen wise, it's actually a very small squarish layout, so you do not have any partition between the kitchen and the utility or service yard space. In fact, if you do not need a dry kitchen space, you can actually extend your kitchen out so that you have a long L-shaped kitchen that you can use for your heavy cooking. But if you do want to do up some partitions between the dry kitchen and the kitchen utility space, then that is at your own cost, because HDB is not going to build up the partition for you. Now you have to note that household shelter is actually nearer to the main door instead of the center. So if you want to do some home renovation, do take that house plan in mind. Next, let's look at the 4-room flat layout and price. We are looking at 320,000 to 393,000. Resale flats nearby, we are looking at around 435 to 535,000, which is a huge margin above the BTO pricing. Layout ideas wise, the internal floor area is actually 90 square meters for the 4-room flat. So this time the 4-room flat looks a bit different from the usual type, because we do have one bedroom actually segregated out from the rest of the two bedrooms. You have your master bedroom and one common bedroom over here. So the master bedroom do come with a larger ensuite toilet compared to the common toilet. And then the other bedroom here is separated instead of connecting to the other common bedroom. So your living and dining space is actually at the center of the apartment, which may be good for some people who may prefer this kind of layout. Otherwise, you can also like put your dining table in the center as well. And then you have like a small study desk that you can utilize here that is above your household shelter. So this kind of layout is actually quite good, because it removes any kind of unwanted space for the dead corridor space, you know, that you can do nothing with it. At least now it has very little dead space, and you can even use it to put a study table. Now for the kitchen wise, sad to say that they are keeping the service yard window and the door. So if you do want to enlarge your kitchen, you have to engage a contractor to hack down the service yard door and the walls and the windows, right, so that your kitchen can be larger. And it's actually an open concept kitchen, so if you do want to have some partition, you have to build that up yourself at your own cost. Now lastly, for your 5-room flat, the price is between $412,000 to $526,000. If you're looking at resale flat nearby, it's around $570,000 to $620,000. And then for the layout ideas, will be a very typical 5-room layout. This time you can see that your living and dining space is actually really large. In fact, so large that you can actually put in a suggested study, which is what some people did for their home office, or you can put your dining set here so that you can actually watch your television while having your meals. And then over here, you can have another dining set if you want, or you do up some kitchen island stuff that people like to do with their 5-room kitchens. You have a slightly larger kitchen space this time compared to the 4-room flat, but you still have your service yard doors and windows, which you also need to engage a contractor to hack down the walls and the windows if you do want to enlarge your kitchen. Household shelter is nearer to the main door as well, so it's not at the center, blocking any kind of space. For the bedroom wise, it's the same, two common bedrooms and one master bedroom with an ensuite toilet, slightly larger than the common toilet. So for Lakeside View, there is also an optional component scheme or OCS. I'm looking at the 5-room flat pricing for the OCS, so we are looking at $6,000 for the flooring. So it will come with vinyl strip flooring in the bedrooms and porcelain floor tiles in the living and dining room. And then around $3,200 for the internal doors and sanitary fittings. That comes with two bedroom doors, two folding bathroom doors, wash basin with tap mixer and shower set for the two bathrooms. So if you felt that my walkthrough has helped you decide whether Lakeside View is a good option for you to select during this May 2022 BTO, do help me comment a thank you at the bottom of the comment section. I'll really appreciate it, and let's get back to the video. Alright folks, welcome back. So I hope that this BTO analysis has helped you to better decide whether this BTO is an ideal location and project site for you. And if you want to look at the subscription rates as of the end of today, you can refer to this table over here, updated from HDB. Also check out my other property videos on this HDB BTO for property playlist right over here. Just click on it and select the favorite video that you want to watch. With that, thank you for watching. My name is Christopher. This is Honey Money HG, steering young adults to financial independence.